Bill Herman. This is the last moments of Midwest DJs Live, reporting for DJ and TV, John Young, and all of you for the Insider. I'm here with a couple of guys from La Force Entertainment.
What's up?
From Dallas, and they were both presenters here. This is you know him. Okay. Matt Rush, and of course, Nate over here. So tell me about your experience of the show.
Yeah.
And how it went for you the last 2 days.
The show was fantastic. Like, everybody is so into connecting with each other and so welcoming. It was just so refreshing. And then, on top of that, the education was fantastic. To the extent that the speakers all knew each other really well. And so I felt like we all kind of played well off each other of like, oh, remember when Joe talked about this yesterday? Call back and remember and take this spin on it. Right. So it was really nice. It was very well thought.
So your presentation was extraordinary.
Oh, thank you.
Lots and lots of people talking about it when it's all done.
Good.
You yourself, did you have any takeaways from either today or yesterday?
No, I've been so overwhelmed all day preparing to speak, and then you just caught me coming off stage. I'm like, I can't process right now.
You really, really did a really beautiful job.
Thank you so much. I'm sorry about that. It was fantastic. It's just, I just came off stage.
Grab Nate here. I want to talk to him a little bit.
Big Nate.
What's up?
So Nate, of course, is one of the presenters as well. Okay, Nate with La Force Entertainment in Dallas as well. Just give a little background again as to what you were talking about.
Okay, cool. So those of you that know me or have seen me around know that I've had a massive change in appearance over the last 8 months. I started a journey back in August. I was 403 pounds, way overweight, wanted to make a change in my life, and got some results really fast. Did everything naturally. I've been truly just working on me and living a really better lifestyle. I had a moment happen to me, so I put it all together, and I really wanted to share the life experience that I had that made me change my life. I think that we live in a fast-paced industry that's constantly going, and we spend, our lifestyle's not very good, where we sometimes will eat late at night, bad, unhealthy foods.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Yeah, for sure. And so I wanted to make a difference. I got to a point where I was not healthy. I didn't enjoy my appearance. It affected my business. It affected my marriage. It affected my relationship with my family. And I found myself living a one-dimensional lifestyle focused mainly on the DJ side of things. Of course, we have a great company, but we're moving fast. And we're doing big things. And so I was so driven on just the business. I thought that if I could do this and we could sell these things and just make more money, that everything else would happen.
Right.
And I was just so one-dimensional, standing on one leg. I started and joined the program to be a four-dimensional person, and today I talked about how the F-Words changed my life, which is a four-dimensional man project, so family, faith, fitness, and finance. So, super pumped to bring that.
Really, very, very important.
Thank you.
I really appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
So, you've been here for 2 days. You were also a person who came to see the show.
Yeah, absolutely.
What were some of your highlights that you take away in the film yesterday and today?
Yeah, definitely. Great speakers. I think the entire conference was put together really, really well. I think that the team, the board, they shared at the end of the show today, you know, that since Christmas, they've been together every Monday night planning this event, and it showed. I really think that all the work that they put behind the scenes to kind of just put together great content, a great team of speakers, it flew all over, man. I mean, this is Midwest DJs Live, but Glenn and I are from Dallas, are people from Orlando, all over. We're all here together, and I think it was a great week of education, a great week of networking, got to meet some new friends, and so I'm really excited about the future of this show and just the future of our business in general, because the DJ industry is growing, and guys are really putting time into their business. That's good.
We're coming back next year.
Absolutely. I'll see you.
Thanks, brother.
Thank you.
See you soon.
Thank you, man.
Come here, Dustin.
Dustin,
come here. Okay, now do not adjust your set. This man is 47 years old. He looks good. Dawson came with his dad, Chris, to the conference. First conference, right? Okay. Young man is how old?
13.
13 years old. And the entire show, everyone's talking about this kid's skills. It's incredible what he's doing. He's got a YouTube channel, right?
Yes.
Yeah. And so now, why did you get into DJing? What made you want to come and hang out with a bunch of middle-aged guys in the Midwest?
So I got into DJing because of my dad had a set of controller downstairs, and my dad works nights, so when I got home from school, he'd be gone, so I'd always like go downstairs and throw stuff together, so that's how I got into DJing. Midwest DJs Live, I like how small the conference is you get time to get one-on-one with the presenters as the one-on-ones in the conference itself. Great conference. If you're looking to go to a first conference, I recommend Midwest.
Well, I'll tell you, because you've been to so many conferences.
Absolutely.
So, you were in every seminar. You showed off your skills one of the first nights, and everyone was like blown away. And everyone going home thinking, he's 13, I've been doing this for 20 years, I'm feeling bad about myself.
I gotta come back and say that this kid right here is the future.
He really, really is.
For real. Like, there's 13-year-olds all over the country trying to get into the DJ game. This kid's in the DJ game.
He is. He's
for
not
real.
Trying.
Turn around. Show him your backpack, bro. Follow. Can you see that? Dawson High. Follow this kid. DJ Dawson High. Instagram, right? DJ Dawson High on Instagram.
Well done. Thank you, Nate. You saw all the seminars. Did you have any favorites?
Nate Nelson's is a good one.
Now it's easy to say he's over here kissing your butt.
Glenn was amazing.
Yeah.
Not that he's standing right in front of me. Who else? There was
he
so
was
many,
hoping for a job. I get it.
There were so many great presenters that you can't even put your finger on a couple.
What do you think? If you had to take away one thing, you're going to go home, and you're going to put it into action, building what you're trying to build, what would it be?
Oh, there's so many little nuggets.
Give me your first one in your head.
528. We're up here to change and get back down.
Definitely keep yourself healthy.
I like that. I like that a lot. So if there's other guys out there your age, between the ages of 12 and 25, okay, who've never been young, that are still trying to figure this out in their basements, okay, but they want to do this, and here you are at 13, what's your advice for them?
Just keep trying at it. You'll get it eventually. Might sound cliche, but it's true.
Who's a better DJ, you or your dad? Yeah, I think so too.
No pointing fingers.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Okay, great. No, thank you, Bernie. You did an amazing job. It was lots and lots of fun. Stick with me, right?
No, I'm good.
Yeah, come on. Andrew. All right. Andrew came to the show. Andrew's from northern Minnesota. So, we were here for 2 days. What was your highlight, let's say, of today's conference? This last game.
Today's part of the conference, I mean, really, it's just giving the clients what they deserve. You know, giving them their absolute most, you know, even if they're paying for, you know, a basic package, still going above and beyond, giving them what they deserve. I mean, it's what we're there to do is help make their day easier, as stress-free as possible. So just helping them, making them a key focus, making their life easier.
What are you going home with today to put in action?
Going home with today, just... I mean, what I'm gonna start doing right away: marketing, advertising. Get those weddings booked.
Gotcha.
They're not gonna get the experience if they don't know about it.
Very nice. Well done, sir. Thanks, Andrew. And I'll see you soon.
Absolutely. Very soon.
Hey, Paul, come here a second. I want to introduce you to another young gentleman here. Paul, you just met the youngest DJ here at the conference.
Oh.
And this, here he is, the second youngest DJ at the conference. This is Paul Whelan. Paul is from Traverse City, Michigan. He drove all the way around the lake to come over to Milwaukee to be a part of this. You were here for 2 days. What did you think of the show?
I thought it was great. But I just came for a free ticket to your pontoon. Minneapolis.
I'll get you
right
on the
pontoon. It was awesome.
Tell me what you wanted. Did you have any highlights of yesterday or today?
Oh, gosh, they're all over. It's like just get out there and be with the people.
Yeah.
Be with the people who do what we do.
And what would you, you're how old now?
I am 73.
73, you're still doing this. You came to a conference. People would think that at 73 you figured it out.
I'm just getting started. I don't know anything. I got to learn. I mean, I've been, 40 years at it. I still got to learn some stuff.
So what was the number one thing you learned? What are you going to take home today, put into action this week?
I don't know. I haven't decided yet. I got so many.
It's pretty overwhelming.
I got to put two or three things in, actually. Yeah,
that's okay.
I mean, right away.
And coming back? You going to do it again?
I plan to.
Awesome. What are you going to tell people if they're thinking about going? What would you say to them?
If you're serious about your business, you really ought to come.
Yeah. Yeah. I'll see you later.
Thank you, Bill.
Awesome. Nice to meet you. Hey, Sue. Okay, you know, DJs, you know, we're a big boys club, and a lot of these conferences, you see mostly men who do this, but regularly I see Sue at just about all the conferences I go to as well. Sue, you're down near the
Chicago.
In Illinois. You were here for 2 days.
Yes.
What do you think of what happened over the last 2 days? Do you have any highlights, things that stuck out to you?
I feel like I got a lot of nice, good content that I can actually use.
Can you give me an example? Give me one.
See, there's just too much. I got so many notes that...
It's hard. It's like something gets to blow up.
Yeah, can you give me just one? I've got like a whole 9-page list of things of notes.
Okay, so if I told you right now from those notes that you took, you had to put something in action tomorrow, what would it be?
Probably start kicking butt on marketing to brides and Pinterest.
Oh, you're in. So Stacy.
Yes.
Stacy this morning. Stacy.
DJ Stacy.
Right. So this girl knows the Pinterest world better than any of us, okay? And if you are not on Pinterest, you really should be. And if you don't know why, you need to look up DJ Stacy Nichols. Stacy Nichols. An amazing presentation. I've seen her a couple of times. And every time that I see it, a lot of people run out and go, oh, I gotta do more of this. She's really, really compelling.
She made it really easy to understand. Easy, right? Yes.
Yeah, exactly. So, and you're in Chicago. What are you doing primarily down there when it comes to shows?
Weddings.
Do you see yourself doing anything else? Is that where you started? Or?
I like weddings best. And I think that's what I do best. So why not do what you do best?
Awesome. Yeah, nice. There you go. That's your seminar.
Thank you for interviewing me, Bill.
Oh, no problem, Sue. Thank you very much. That's awesome. Perfect. Tyler, you want to say a couple things?
Sure, I'll say a couple things.
Tyler, who are you?
How's it going, Bill?
Tyler, tell everybody where you're from.
I'm from Appleton, Wisconsin.
Awesome. You've been here the last couple of days.
Okay. Yeah.
I've seen you in every one of the seminars. I saw you on the show floor. What was your favorite part of it?
Just the knowledge. Just learning how to take care of our couples. Everything from how to market better. Just listen to your couples. That's the biggest thing I took away. Listen to their needs. Just shut up and listen to them. You can get so much information by listening to your couples. Just taking care of your health is a big one. We learned how to take care of your health. But, you know, making time for your family. So many DJs get so tied up in their DJ business and don't take time for their own personal family and life. There's so much good knowledge here, and I'd recommend buying a ticket.
I really agree. You need to come back next year.
I already got my ticket bought.
Awesome. So do I. In fact, it's going to be down at downtown Milwaukee, I believe, at the Hyatt. But I'm going to ask somebody right now. So
I believe it was the Hyatt and free parking.
There you go. Free parking.
Thanks, Bill.
Hey, Travis, can you come over here for a second? I want you to say hello to the folks at DJMTV.
Okay.
We're doing a wrap-up of the last day of the conference. This gentleman here is like the lifeblood of what's happening. Everything that happened in the show, he was behind doing something else, making something else happen. He's been a part of this volunteer team since Midwest DJs began. Really?
Yeah, well, I've been on it for the last 5 years. Last 5 years.
Okay, so this show, pretty extraordinary.
It's an incredible show.
Yeah, did you have any highlighted moments for yourself as someone watching it?
I would say yes. That's a tough question because my perspective is to give.
Right.
And that's what our show is about. And so, again, my responsibility here is to make sure that the train stays on the track and everything's running smooth. But seeing the enjoyment of the attendees that are here and seeing their eyes light up and seeing kind of what they took away. I personally, to be a little selfish here, I personally really enjoyed Glenn Walsh being here. I really thought, and a lot of people I think haven't seen him. And I think that it was amazing to see him up there on the stage and the message that he had. It was very straightforward.
So you give back in this. And if, those of you who don't know, every person involved with Midwest DJ Live, first of all, it's a nonprofit group that has been putting this show on for a very long time, way before it was even here at the Pottawatomie. And many people don't know that all these people that do all this work to put this on, and it's not just a few people. a full group of guys before the hotel gets involved are all volunteers. You are a volunteer. You've been volunteering for 5 years.
Yeah.
What keeps you coming back? I mean, you guys don't just show up the day it starts and go on the day. And you're here days before.
Yeah.
You're here days afterwards.
Yeah.
You guys are meeting every single week with nothing to show for it in a compensation of monetary. So what is it that keeps you doing this?
The love of what we do.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, if you're not in this for the passion, what drives you every day, you got to have a defined reason why you get out of bed every day, right? Is it to be a better person? Is it to help other people? And what is it that drives you? And for me, I just love doing this. I love being able, whether it's helping a bride and groom or a charity event or a former event or seeing other people that walk like you, talk like you, have the same interests, be able to succeed. Because the thing is, the reality of it is, I don't want this to become an infomercial, but you know what? You can't have people in life as a whole succeed unless you have some sort of assistance, right? I got that assistance at some point in my life, one of the people that got me here, right? And at some point, you have to pay that forward or pay it back. And so I'm constantly aware of that, trying to be humble and doing that. And this is a great way to do that, by giving back to DJs. They give so much by doing all these different events. And so that small little part helps out me a little way, and I'm on board, and I've been on board.
So from that volunteer standpoint for this weekend, was there a favorite moment that you saw happening that maybe we didn't see?
All kinds of scenes.
What was your favorite thing that you got a chance to get out of this? Like seeing something happen, anything like that?
I don't know. I mean, I'll probably reflect on all that after the fact. I mean, again, there's so much going on while we're here. I mean, you still have to tear down and everything. You probably saw this. I got people yelling at me, to make sure that everything's good. But no, I mean, it is a whirlwind. And what we do is you know, a few days afterwards, there's a cooling down period where we're able to reflect back on everything that went well and everything that maybe could have been better. And then we start planning for next year. I mean, what everybody doesn't know is that we meet every Monday night and take time out of our families to make sure that that we're able to put this together. And there's a lot of preparation, a lot of time, and a lot of sacrifice. And again, the thing is that somebody asks yourself, well, if you did this for all these years, then why would you come back the next year? Whatever. The board, we become like family.
Really? You guys really are?
We're close.
Really
close. We're
close.
We care about each other. We want to make sure that, again, that we're all doing, because we're all invested on the same level. And again, this, here's the deal. We're driving a bus. You got to know who are in the seats, who's doing this and doing that, and we have a really good team. Everybody's in the right place.
Yeah.
Everybody's in the right place, and it works. It's going to continue to work. We hope that if you're not here, I don't know why not, but we want you to come and join us. It's a great conference. It's going to get better. And so we're just thankful for everybody that's here.
Remind everybody again next year where we're going to be.
Next year we're going to be the Hyatt Regency in downtown Milwaukee. It's right on the Riverwalk.
Really
there's
beautiful.
Lots of breweries. Absolutely. There's a beer museum down there. There's shopping. It's right by the Pfizer, the new arena where the Bucks are playing.
Yeah, where they sell all those little blue pills.
absolutely. I think it's going to be awesome. It's the next step in the evolution of Midwest DJs Live, and we hope that if you're watching, that you'll come join us.
Yeah, absolutely. And from what I understand, if you go to the website today, and only today until the end of the day, tickets for next year, $11.59, you can get these tickets for $99. And the most expensive ticket to come, like a week ago, was how much?
You could get a ticket for $179.
$179, probably as much as $200 by the end of the year next year.
Yeah.
But you can get it for less than $100, but you got to get it today. And it is a smaller show, so these tickets sell very, very quickly. So you should get those as quickly as you can.
There's great value here. Everybody will keep saying value, incredible value, incredible content, a way for you to be able to get better. You got to have some skin in the game, right?
You really do.
If you want to get better, you got to take the time to be here. It's a small investment for a huge return. That's my Donald Trump.
Yeah.
Huge return.
Huge. Do me a favor, ask Ronnie to come over here and we'll line this thing up, okay?
Absolutely.
Awesome. So John Young wanted me to do this. He couldn't be here himself. So as your reporter, okay, from Midwest DJs Live, remember, my show came out yesterday, every Wednesday. It's the Creative License Podcast. And I want to introduce you to one more guy before we go. This is Big Ron, and every year he does the Big Ron spinoff. It's a big highlight of the show every single solitary year. Tell me a little bit about how you started the spinoff and why you keep coming back and doing it. It's hard work.
It is. When we first started, we decided to try to find something to do for us to all hang out at.
Right.
So we decided to, one time it was roller skating, and then the following year after that, we said, we're going to go bowling. So next few years after that, we decided to do
bowling.
But
even in bowling, you were doing the spinoff.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. And then we had the setups at the bowling alley. We had like six or seven turntables and whatever else and controllers, and that's when we started the spinoff. That's when we started it, and we figured DJs playing for DJs.
It's quite the highlight every year, man. People cannot stop. It happens on the Sunday before, and then people, I mean, they're still talking about leaving, and they're still talking about how the spinoff went. And it's become yours. It's Big Ron's spinoff, man. How long have you been DJing?
I have been DJing since I was 14.
14?
So
and you're like
17
years. Now?
I'm like, yeah, right. Yeah, it's almost 30 years. I've been doing
this. And you're still doing the clubs. You're still working on your skills. You don't you don't see yourself getting to a place where you've got this down.
I'm just always trying to find something different, always something new, and that's what's so nice about, you know, this, you know, really is. And I like listening to other DJs and how they do things, because sometimes I get set in my ways and I need to change up.
So this year, good show?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah,
did you have any highlights of your own?
Oh, man. Well, the spinoff was great.
Yeah,
I mean, I really like Spinelli's.
Nick Spinelli, he was really amazing.
That was just awesome, what he did. And then the actual production of it that Zachary did for that was just on point.
Right.
So I really enjoyed it.
That's very cool. Do you get a chance to meet that kid?
Oh, yeah. Dawson. Yeah, 13 years old.
Dawson, hi. I mean, you've been doing this for how many years?
Yeah.
And this kid is doing that kind of work?
Yeah, I was like, oh, my gosh. You
guys got to get a spot for him next year. We're going to all come to watch him speak.
Yeah, I was very impressed. He's been doing it for a while.
Right, well, do you remember, I mean, when you started back in the day, right?
Yeah.
And were you even close to those kind of skills when you started?
No, I mean, well, you know, back then we had catalogs to look up for here. So we're like, will it work, will it not work? What will it sound like? We don't know. So, yeah, that's how that goes.
It was pretty amazing. Did any one speaker that you saw other than Spinelli that you say, hey, if you missed it, you should see it?
Joe Bunn, I think it's so impressive, and also Big Daddy. I mean, the compassion that he has when he speaks, it hits home.
Yeah, really nice. So if you had to tell somebody, nobody's been to a conference ever, okay, and they're thinking about coming into the middle of the heartland, okay, Milwaukee, Wisconsin on Lake Michigan, to come to Midwest DJs Live, the little show that could, why would they, should they come?
It's down home. It has a down home feeling to it. It's not so big to the point where you lose people. Everybody pretty much knows everybody here. That's what's nice. And it's just a huge network.
Yeah. Ron, it's a pleasure. You guys are doing great work. Thanks a lot.
Thank you very much.
No problem. And one more time, I want to introduce you to Brian here. Brian, he lives in Ohio. He came all the way here for the conference himself. Brian Harris. And you want to tell them a little bit about why you went? I mean, it's not a small trip for you.
No.
To come from Ohio.
No,
so why here?
Well, last year was my first time here, and because I wanted to branch out and just check out the show, and I was very impressed with just the overall production. The obviously the content was great, and I was like, well, it's a 6.5 hour drive with you know my body break, and I gotta come.
He had a body break.
I had a body break.
So you saw all the presenters. I saw you in everything.
Yep.
So any highlights? Yeah, tell me, yesterday, what was your big highlight? What was your takeaway, your favorite one?
Kara probably was my favorite.
Yeah, she started the day off.
Yeah, and just a great perspective on all the different, you know, age groups.
Yeah.
Things that I, now that I know what I know, I wish I could go back and just approach these different age groups in a different way. You know?
Yeah, I think one of the things that we all kind of got out of it was you got to millennials is how we've been bashing them all and how probably we shouldn't be.
Exactly.
Yeah, well, not even probably. We shouldn't be.
Yeah, we shouldn't be.
Not at all.
No.
That was great. What about today? What was your thing for today? One or two or something you really, really stuck out for you?
I think Glenn Rausch is really
just, and I don't think he's presented more at all. Really,
I've never seen him present at all.
But his presentation was spot on.
Yeah,
yeah. What was it about you liked?
That's a very big question.
It is a big question. Just pick one. It's all right.
Let me check my notes here. Let's see. I just say just kind of being more of an entrepreneur versus being a self-employed.
That was a very interesting distinction, wasn't it?
Yeah.
I think many of us that are self-employed see ourselves as entrepreneurs, and many people who are entrepreneurs, we think we are, but we really are self-employed.
Right.
And it was a very interesting distinction that he made.
Yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And you remember what that was? How he split them up?
Mm. Help me out here.
So if I remember correctly, the distinction he was making is that entrepreneurs are somebody who's self-employed is not necessarily an entrepreneur because what they've done is created a job for themselves.
Yeah.
Okay. A way to get paid to doing the thing they were doing for somebody else, but to really just keeping a job, right? Whereas an entrepreneur is building something outside of themselves that is something that they can run on its own and be sold at some point.
Yeah.
So building a business as opposed to building yourself the job that you can continue to do that you were doing for somebody else because you thought you'd make more money. And oftentimes when, from what I got from him and what I see as well, because I didn't use those words to make those distinctions, is once you are an entrepreneur and looking at the business as opposed to just looking at trying to keep yourself working, then you're actually building a thing for the future.
Yep.
You're building a future for yourself, for your family, and a chance to be able to say, I don't want to do this thing anymore. A chance to be able to make a profit and keep going when there are problems and things that show up, which we don't take into consideration when we're just working for ourselves.
That's right.
Yeah.
I've always viewed myself as self-employed.
Yeah, me too.
You know?
Yeah.
And so, yeah, I couldn't have said it better.
I think you could have. So a bunch of people are going to ask you, or let's say they're asking you right now, you went 2 years in a row.
You're
coming back next year?
I already got my ticket.
Okay, so why? Why are you coming to Midwest DJs Live? I know you go to Mobile Beat as well. You've been to the other shows.
I go to R&D
DJs. There's a lot of shows that we all go to. What is it about this one that people should be excited about?
Just overall the content. The production is great. Everything is kept on time.
Yeah.
That's just
that's a
pet peeve of mine. Like if you got to get home, you want it to end on time, and you got to catch a plane, which I don't. But if I did, I'd want to be able to see the entire show, not have to leave because it wasn't kept on track.
Yeah.
In fact, I think we were on ahead of schedule on a few times.
Yeah, I think so too. So. All right. Brian Harris.
Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot, man.
All right.
Take care. I'll see you next year.
Okay.
So there you have it. That's our report from Midwest DJs Live. It happens every single year, and it's going to continue again, Midwest 2020, next year here in Milwaukee. I don't have the specific dates, but it is the last Sunday, Monday, Tuesday of April. The last Sunday, Monday, Tuesday of April, 26th through the 28th. I just heard from Paul over there. So if you want to be a part of it, of course, you just go to Midwest DJs Live website, buy yourself a ticket today because you can get it now for 99 cents. And all of you who couldn't be there, us from DJN TV, John Young, myself, we wanted to be sure you got a little taste of what was happening, a little bit of information, some insider information as you like to get from here. So if you couldn't go, you get an idea of what happened and maybe get a little jealous and you come and be a part of it, because as much as you can learn online, you'll learn even more when you are one of these things that are live. We would want you to be a part of it live, too. I'm Bill Herman. Don't forget about my show every Monday, the Creative License Podcast, and then, of course, every great show on DJN TV. So thanks again, and we'll see you next year for Midwest DJs Live.